Hey guys, this is Tyler here from Rehab to Fab Designs. I am working on sealing this piece that you see behind me. It's a chest on chest. I'm actually trying to record a tutorial for you guys for glazing. And these are the pretty drawer fronts right here. Nice, beautiful curvy piece. We painted these in Wiesel Fall 2019 color called Isles Avenue. Very pretty white. Antique Villa has been my previous go-to white. I think I actually like this one better. It's has a little more, just a little bit more cream color to it, but not cream, not yellow at all. Really, really pretty neutral white. We are sealing. So this piece was primed. It has two coats of paint on it, and we are in process of sealing it. When we do glazes, we always seal after we put our paint on, because chalk paint is very porous in nature, and so it will grab your glaze, and you'll have a little bit less control on it. I have Bella, the shop dog, here with me. She's chewing on everything and trying to sit in my lap. But when you start putting your glaze on, if you haven't sealed first, it will be it will really grab that glaze and give you just a lot less control when you're trying to wipe it back. So we are sealing with Wiesel matte varnish. Has a little bit of sheen to it, but not too much. I'm using a cling-on brush to apply it. It's a S30, one of the short handled ones. So that's what I'm oh, do y'all see my struggle? This shop dog, oh, she wants to be in somebody's lap constantly. Look at how sweet. Anyways, the reason I got on here, I was going to do a little Tuesday tip for you guys and show you, talk to you about sealing with these on a detailed piece. You want to be careful not to put too much in those areas, because it will yellow. So there are really two different kinds of sealers you can use. You can use a urethane based sealer, or like a polycrylic instead of a polyurethane. The urethanes will really yellow over time, especially on these lighter colored paints like whites and light pinks and such. So you don't really want to use those on them, because you will see it in a very short amount of time that it will yellow and change color on you. So polycrylics are designed not to do that. They don't have the urethane in them. They're pretty good for high use areas, but not quite as good as a urethane. However, again, you just it works a lot better on stains, darker wood stains or darker paint colors. If we're using a dark color, we'll use a urethane base, just because it is a little more durable, but not on any kind of light colors. So this is a water-based product, so it should have minimal to no yellowing. And we're just putting this on, probably, hopefully one good coat, maybe two, just depends. Glazing pieces is really a lot of work, because a lot of steps for us. So we, of course, prep everything and then, you know, prime it as well. And then two coats of paint for this. We got really good coverage with that. Got a white primer underneath, so we got really good coverage with two coats of paint. And then at least one coat of this top coat, this matte varnish, potentially two. I'll let it dry and see if there's any areas I missed that I need to go back and get. And again, using my cling-on, because it is a water-based product, it will wash right off. Hey, guys. So these cling-ons are really versatile. You can really use them for anything. So that's it. When you do finish, after you don't work it too much, you don't want to have brush strokes in it. If you keep going, it will kind of pull. So when you get done, after you've applied it everywhere, just check around your edges and make sure you don't have any runs anywhere, because if you do have any areas of the product where it sits thicker, it will leave a heavier area that is has more potential to yellow. So on to what I wanted to show you guys. This is a really heavily detailed piece on the drawer here. And so what I wanted to tell you is, when you're using this, to make sure you don't leave this varnish too heavy around those low spots, because if you do, that's going to be more likely to yellow. So I'm using my Klingon again and just kind of dabbing it around those little tight corners around it, and then brushing it back off. But again, if you leave it heavy and it kind of sits in those low spots, like in those little tight corners that you can kind of see in here, that's where it will have the potential to yellow. So make sure you wipe that back really well. I usually go over the whole thing and try to go back before it dries. And we are going around the edges to, one, to seal it and help protect it. We will spray this again after we're done with glazing. We will come back and seal it again. But I'm just going ahead and putting a coat on here, just because if I get, I'm probably not going to try to apply the glaze per se around the edges. I may just leave them as is, but if I get it on there, it's going to really grab because, again, of the porosity there of the chalk paint. So I've got all that applied, and then just really brushing this on right here. And just making sure you go around it. You might want to give it a minute or two and then kind of come back. And make sure it's not too heavy in those recessed areas. I think that's it. Look at this dog, y'all. Sweet, sweet Bella. That's it. If you have any questions, please drop them down in the comments. I'm not going to stay on here because I've, like I say, trying to record some tutorials for you guys, but just wanted to teach you guys about the varnish right there. If you have any questions, be sure and post them in the comments. As always, thanks for watching. We appreciate it. Bye.